I am here today with a very good comrade of ours. This is the fellow who helped us get into MTAC. He actually introduced us to MTAC. We probably wouldn't have known about it if not for him. So I'm going to turn it over to him.
Hello, Cosplayer Nation. I am Gerard. Right now I'm running SPN Creatives, which is on YouTube. It's a channel dedicated to cosplayers who show off their cosplay talent in the southern region of the United States, in states like Tennessee, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, Florida, or whoever comes up. Right now I'm residing in Nashville, Tennessee.
So what's the absolute limit, if any, for you? Like, will you go out to California, or would you go out to Midwest United States for a con?
Another great question. When you go to a con, and when you're like me and you're watching all of these cosplay fan videos, because you'll see that most of the cons in the video are from, you know, conventions in California and in Maryland. So I've considered going out to Maryland, which is about the farthest I would go for a convention. But when, like, again, like I said, when it comes to making sure you have all your resources together, it becomes a little difficult. It's just a matter of having the time and the money and the resources to do it. I've recently been to Comic-Con, which is not Comic-Con, but K-A-M-I-Con, which is in Alabama, which was another great convention. For me, that was the closest thing that, to me, looked like MTAC. The convention center was almost the same layout, almost the same atmosphere in terms of cosplays. There were some great cosplayers, some great people that I met with BHTV as well. So Comic-Con was great. GMX is another great con. If you're not too big on anime and you want to feel like you're more into the like the Doctor Who and the various like geek culture related events, then GMX, which is the Geek Media Expo in Nashville, is also great, which is usually held around October, but I think it's going to be in November this year. Just MTAC in general is going to be absolutely ridiculous for SPN Creatives and just about everyone who's going to be there. I tend to follow a ton of cosplayers on Facebook. MTAC is going to be really interesting this year in terms of doing photography and videography, especially with the new convention center that we have, or the new convention center that we're using for the convention, because we used to be in a hotel. Now we're in a convention center, so it's a much bigger space.
What got you into anime and cosplay to begin with?
This is going to sound very fairly obvious. I mean, I was one of those kids who grew up on Toonami. If anybody's familiar with Toonami, that's definitely what got me into anime. But I think it was really just, I guess it was the content of the anime and how, you know, how the characters were drawn and the stories. And it was definitely Toonami that I can give credit to for getting me into anime. And then cosplay was just a whole different thing once I found out about conventions in high school. So I think people are leaving behind a pretty good legacy. I think there's a pretty healthy future for cosplay videography, even if there are people who won't be around to do cosplay videography forever. So as long as there's people cosplaying, there's always going to be cosplay videos. So, and people are getting better and better with their cosplays every year, so there's always something to look forward to shooting on video and getting photos of. If anyone's watching this video right now, MTAC is going to be in Nashville, Tennessee, Easter weekend, which is March 29th through the 31st. You should definitely stop by if you're interested. There should be some really great events going on and some great cosplayers there. In terms of SPN Creatives, I am on YouTube.com, and the handle is SPN and Creatives. If you just Google it, it should be up there. But there's also a Flickr page. There's a Vimeo page for where some of my works are. So everything is just under SPN Creatives. If you look it up, it should be there.